Hello, hello. So, coming at you today to talk about, I see the world on a pretty individualized basis. I don't make a whole lot of global generalizations for the most part. And so, my purpose of coming to you today is to really do some smashing of some stereotypes that really, really, really bug me. And so, the first one is just the stereotype of behavior therapy in general. So, I feel like there is this misconception that people feel like for their child or individual or loved one, whomever, to be a participant in a behavior therapy type service model, that they have to be completely out of control behaviorally and have tons of challenging behaviors. And we kind of have this stereotype of they're kicking and screaming and biting and hitting and all of these things. And y'all, that's not the case. The largest and most important concept of applied behavioral analysis is really going in and targeting areas of skill deficits. And so, who's going to benefit from this? People that have areas of skill deficits, whether it's communication, whether it is a behavioral deficit of some type or excess. Maybe you're seeing things too frequently compared to what might be norm. It might be daily living skills. It might be an academic area. It might be social skills. So really going in and smashing that stereotype that behavior therapy is not just for people who have this stereotypical out of control behavior. The next stereotype that I would like to go ahead and smash is the fact that applied behavioral analysis creates little robots. And so there, I think if you have some knowledge or experience with applied behavioral analysis, ABA therapy, you might have seen videos or seen bits of therapy where it looks like touch red, get a Skittle, touch blue, get a Skittle, touch red, no wrong answer, touch red, touch red. And the misconception is then you have children that aren't generalizing those skills and they're coming home and they can't touch red, and all they can do is in mass trial, touch red, touch red, touch red, touch red, get my Skittle. And so let me just go ahead and tell you that's not good ABA therapy. That's not clean ABA therapy. Good and effective quality ABA therapy is programming for generalization, and it does not look like robotic therapy creating little robots. With that being said, too, ABA therapy, good, effective, quality ABA therapy programs for generalization. And so, there are some times where mass trial might be necessary in order to correct and prompt and teach a new skill, but that is not what the majority of it looks like. It should look different. It should look fun. It should look different, but similar to just natural teaching strategies in a much more highly structured way. The next stereotype that I would like to really go ahead and also smash at this time is that ABA therapy is only for younger children and that it's just for super young children with autism, and that's the time that you go in and get that early intervention, and by the time they're school aged, they're not participating in ABA therapy anymore. Wrong. Everyone can benefit from ABA therapy. ABA therapy for a 2-year-old is going to look a lot different than ABA therapy for a 15-year-old, but we are programming for lifelong generalization of lifelong important skills. So, whether that is a social skill, whether that is an employment skill, whether that is shaving, whether that is toilet training early on, there is not a skill off the table for us to address in ABA therapy. The next stereotype that I would also like to go ahead and smash at this time is that ABA therapy looks like a therapist in an apron or a fanny pack with M&Ms or some type of small edible, and we're just following people around. Good job, get this. Good job, have an M&M. Oh, right answer, have a Skittle. That kind of goes back to that robotic stereotype that we would like to go ahead and smash, that that's not what ABA therapy is. Early on, there might be some edibles involved if that's the highest, most valuable, only reinforcer that we can use, but all reinforcers are eventually faded. ABA therapy programs to go in and target skills that are aversive, that are really difficult, they're difficult skills that we're targeting. So yes, there might be edibles. Yes, there might be some iPad time. Yes, there might be music. Yes, there might be lots of sing-songy praises and all different types of reinforcers to be able to increase those future frequency participation responses in the therapy itself. But it's not a fanny pack. It's not an apron. I'm not following people around doing kind of a pigeon-like training. That's not quality ABA therapy programming for generalization. The last stereotype that I would also like to smash is that ABA therapy is for individuals on the autism spectrum only. It's not the case. Principles of applied behavioral analysis really apply to everyone. Use it with your loved ones. Use it with your spouse. Use it with your typically developing children. Use it with your animals. Use it with your coworkers. Use it with your supervisees, supervisors. Really, behavior is behavior. All humans display behavior, and this is real life stuff. It's real life effective, and it is life altering, life changing when done correctly. So just to refresh those stereotypes that I went ahead and wanted to smash, the first one is that people have to be out of control behaviorally to get behavior therapy. Smash it. The second stereotype that I would like to smash is that ABA therapy creates little robots. Smash. Third one is that ABA therapy is for younger children only. Smash it. Fourth one is that ABA therapists are in fanny packs and we're delivering edibles one at a time, following people around. Smash it. And the fifth and final stereotype that let's just go ahead and get rid of at this time is that ABA therapy is effective for children on the spectrum only. Smash it.